The following film is a training video for nurses or caregivers about fall risk and risk reduction strategies for the mature adult. According to the International Osteoporosis Foundation, hip fractures cause the most morbidity, with mortality rates up to 20 to 24% into the first year after a hip fracture. A greater risk of dying may persist for at least 5 years afterwards. One out of three adults over the age of 65 and one out of two over the age of 80 falls annually. Risk factors for falls include older age, lower limb weakness, slower gait, and decreased mobility, just to name a few. One of the most serious consequences of falls is fracture. Bone fractures are a serious threat to independence and mortality. The lifetime risk of having any type of fracture, 70% among white women age 50 and older, and fractures are a major contributor to morbidity and to the high cost of medical care. The timed up and go test, also referred to as TUG, can be used as a helpful tool to determine risk for falls among older adults. The timed up and go is a performance test measuring functional mobility and is appropriate to evaluate risk for frail and independent patients. The main elements of this test are gait, lower body strength, balance, and mobility. This test is not applicable for fit seniors. Strengths of this test include that it is easy to administer, quick, and it is easy to distinguish between independent and those who need help with everyday activities. To set up this test, place a chair against a wall. Make sure that the chair is sturdy and won't slip or move during the test. Next, measure a distance of 3 meters away from the front edge of the chair. Place a cone or other available marker that is easily visible at the 3 meter mark.
To begin the test, we're going to have you sit down, leaning slightly forward with your hands on your thighs. I have a stopwatch, and when I say go on the count of three, you're going to get up as fast and safe as possible and walk around this cone right here. Make sure you walk all the way around, and then you're going to come and sit down, and as soon as you sit down, I'm going to stop the time, okay? And so we'll do a practice round right here. Ready? One, two, three, go. And if she needs assistance, I'm going to make sure to watch her so that if there's any accommodations that need to be made. And stop. And once she stops and sits down, then I'm going to stop the timer. So that was the practice round, and now we're going to do the real test. I'm going to count to three again and then say go. One, two, three, go.
Make sure to demonstrate the test to the patient and have them practice once, or have them recite the test to you to ensure understanding. If the patient has a walking device, it is okay to let them use this during the test. It is important that individuals are wearing their regular walking shoes during this task, so be sure to let anyone coming to the test let them know ahead of time. Interpreting the results is important to determining mobility status of patients. This test is helpful in identifying patients who are at a greater risk for falls. If a patient's time is less than 20 seconds, they are considered independent. Individuals who take more than 30 seconds to complete the timed up-and-go task are at a high risk for falls and likely need assistance in everyday living activities. Anyone scoring 14 seconds or longer is at an increased risk of falls compared to those who complete the task in less than 14 seconds. Research has shown that adults who have an extreme fear of falling often limit their physical activity, thus increasing the chance of muscular atrophy. Seniors who depend on outside care may be receptive if the caregiver is afraid they may fall. Therefore, the patient may assimilate the caregiver's fear onto herself and may personally limit their own mobility. This behavior leads to a decreased functional ability and therefore an increased fall risk. While working with older individuals, it is important to remember to be confident in your work. Make sure to give older individuals the opportunity to do as many functional activities that they are able. And remember to try and control your fears. Here are some strategies that we recommend for patients identified as being at risk for falls. Of particular importance are activities that can improve functional mobility. Most importantly, higher levels of physical activity, including walking, have shown 30 to 50% reduction in osteoporotic fractures. At the very least, getting your patient up and walking will significantly reduce the risk for falls. Research has shown that adding 1 hour per week of walking at an average pace creates a 6% reduction in risk for hip fractures. If your patient is sedentary, encourage them to walk for 10 minutes 3 times per week. At their tolerance, increase this time by 5 minutes each week. Try to work up to an hour to gain the most benefit to protect against falls. If your nursing facility has a treadmill, this is preferred over walking outside to avoid uneven surfaces and is easier to supervise.
When performing tangent stands, stand directly next to a table or chair. Place your feet slightly apart. Place one foot in front of the other as though you are walking across the balance beam. Hold this position for 10 to 30 seconds. Repeat with opposite foot. When performing one-leg stands, stand directly behind a table or chair and place feet slightly apart. Slowly bend one knee towards your chest, lifting your foot 6 inches off the floor. Hold this position for 10 to 30 seconds. Repeat with opposite leg. When performing leg raises, stand next to a table or chair and place your feet slightly apart. Lift one leg 6 inches out to the side, front, or back. Hold this position for 10 to 30 seconds. Repeat with opposite leg.
Research has shown that nurses often have enough knowledge of their patient, which is a valid source for predicting falls. Remember to be confident in your judgment.
Your shadow walks faster than you. You don't really know.